That's cool. We're going to be doing some worshiping, some dancing. Now I hear, how about you guys come stand in front of me? I hear this one of these songs that we're going to be doing. The second one is one of Isaac's favorite songs. This is Isaac right here, and it's one of his favorite songs. And it requires some crowd participation. We're going to make our waves, right? Yeah, we're going to make our waves. Everybody do this. These are our waves of mercy and our waves of grace. But first, I want to sing about Jesus, right? We sing these songs to Jesus every morning, every Sunday morning. And this song specifically talks about when Jesus died and then rose again so that we could go and be in heaven with Jesus one day, right? He paid that price for us. So we're going to sing about one of the most happy days that we've ever had in the world. So when I say, oh, happy day, I want you to put your hands up and do this, like this. Let me see your happy hands. Come on. Now, I'm going to be playing guitar, so I need some crowd participation here. You guys ready? It goes like this.
History. Death is beaten, you have rescued me. Sing it out, Jesus is alive.
The empty cross,
the empty cross, the empty grave. Life eternal, you have won the day. Shout it out, Jesus is alive. He's alive. Wash my sin away. Oh, happy day, happy day. I'll never be the same. Oh, happy day, happy day. Forever I am changed.
Yes.
When I stand in that place, free at last, meeting face to face, I'm yours, Jesus, you are mine.
Endless
joy and perfect peace. Death is vain and finally we'll see. Celebrate, Jesus is alive. He's alive. You wash my sin away. Oh, happy day, happy day. Forever I am changed. Oh, happy day, happy day. Forever I am changed. Oh, happy day, happy day. You wash my sin away. Oh, happy day, happy day. Forever I am changed.
Yeah, you guys like it? Come on.
And oh, what a glorious day. What a glorious way. That you have saved me. And oh, what a glorious day. What a glorious way. What a glorious way that you
you guys did great. Are you guys ready to get your waves on? Let me see your waves. Here we go.
Every move I'm making you. You make me move, Jesus. Every breath I take, I'm breathing you. Every step I take, I'm taking you. You are my way, Jesus. Every breath I take, I'm breathing you.
Let's sing that again.
Every move I make, I'm making you. You are me, Jesus. Every breath I take, I'm breathing you. Every step I take, I'm taking you. You are my way, Jesus. Every breath I take, I'm breathing you.
Sing waves of mercy. Come on.
Waves of mercy, waves of grace. Everywhere I look, I see your face. Your love has captured me. Oh my God, this love, how can it be?
Yeah. Sing la la la.
La 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 la.
Keep it going.
Sing la 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 la
la la la la la
la la
la la la
la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la.
You guys ready for your waves?
La 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 la. Ways of mercy, ways of grace. Everywhere I look, I see your face. Your love has captured me. Oh my God, this love, how can it be?
Sing la
la. La 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 la.
Sing waves.
Waves of mercy, waves of grace. Everywhere I look, I see your face. Your love has captured me. Oh my God, this love, how can it be? La 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 la
la la la
la la la
la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la.
You guys want to see your waves? You guys ready for waves? Here we go.
Waves of mercy, waves of grace. Everywhere I look, I see your face. Your love has captured me. Oh my God, this love, how can it be? Can it be?
Well, good morning. I think Dusty's going to do the tithe and declaration this morning because I need a minute.
He should be feeling good because he was up in the mountains where there's no oxygen. All right, so we're going to continue with our worship by taking up our tithe and offering. You know, this is a very important time. This is part of submission to God. We talked about this over the last couple weeks. This is just one other way that we glorify God, and that's what we are created to do. And I just love to point out that this is the one area that God said, hey, you can even test me here, and I will prove to you that I keep my promises. And so I encourage you to do that. We're going to say our tithe declaration together. You know how I feel about this. Say it like you mean it. Declare it over your family. Declare it over your finances. Say it together. This is my tithe. It will do what God says it will do. As I try my Lord, he will open the windows of heaven and pour out blessings that cannot be contained. I declare at this moment, I'm surrounded by God's blessings. I'm the seed of Abraham. And what God declared to him, you shall not lack any good thing, applies to me today. In accordance with his word, I will walk in his divine favor and prosperity. No weapons formed against me or my family will succeed, and everything I put my hand forward to do will prosper. I thank God for his mighty power, provision, and plan through Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. Let's pray. Lord God, once again, we just thank you for your mighty power, provision, and plan. God, we thank you that your plan is so much better than ours, and we thank you that you made us a part of your plan. And God, today we pray that as people give, maybe for the very first time, that you will make it evident immediately that you are keeping your promises. And God, that you will create testimony in people's lives as they begin to tithe obediently to you, Lord. And God, we pray for the leadership of this church. As always, God, that you would speak to us and that you would give us clear direction as to what you want done with every penny of these finances. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. You guys can sit down for just a minute. We love our when we have our kids up here, and we would love to have testimonies when our kids are up here. And so we take a minute during praise and worship. If people have a testimony that they want to share, we like to hear it. So if anybody has a testimony, I see Tamara marching up here. I can't tell if she's coming to kick Larry or if she's coming for the microphone. I'm assuming it's for the microphone.
Good morning. I do have a praise. I am so excited about this because this is just one of the myriad of practical ways that God really moves in our lives, and I want to take the moment to honor it. So I would say that I have spent the majority of my adult life like paying off medical bills. It seems like it's a hobby. It's not my favorite thing to do, but it's just the way it goes. And just recently, I got a bill for Steve had surgery a year ago. It was last January. And I just got a bill again for it. And I thought, what the heck? I've paid this. Why am I getting another bill for this? And so I'm calling, and you know, nobody, it requires like three different calls to three different places over and over again to start getting answers. And it just turns out that our insurance, even though the MRI that the bill was for was so that they could do the surgery, Blue Cross Blue Shield said it wasn't medically necessary and just denied it to the tune of $988 that we were on the hook for. And I'm like, I don't want to pay this. This is why I have insurance, right? So I just think, okay, let me just call the people. But also the whole time I am just praying. And you know what? This blew me away. After I talked to Blue Cross Blue Shield, then I got back on the phone with the biller that had sent me the remainder that Blue Cross Blue Shield refused to pay. They literally just told me, you know what? You've already paid your portion. I'll just zero it out. $1,000, you guys. And I want to tell you, this never happened until we tithed. Like, fully. Before, like I said, I've been paying medical bills, and it was always like, oh, I can't tithe the full amount because I have all these bills. I'll tell you, once we just took that leap and just chose obedience over circumstance, we've not had the problems that we did before we started tithing. So one, praise God for caring about our issues and just handling it. But also, man, I got to tell you, if you are on the fence about tithing, where you're supposed to tithe, like just remember that opens the door for God to now be in charge of your finances and not just you. I got to share that every time. Praise God. Thanks.
Amen. We'd be right there. Does anybody else have any testimonies? We're speaking at our leadership retreat about how important giving even little testimonies is to God. So if you have some, please feel free to come up.
Excellent.
I was just going to say, we drove up to the retreat, Westcliff, yes. And I went by myself. Larry wasn't able to go. And so I got up there, and Dusty said, text me when you get up there, and I'll help bring your stuff up to the lodge. And I got out of the car, and he was just arriving. And, man, my car smelled hot. It did not smell good. And we were like, uh-oh, maybe there's an oil problem. Maybe there's this, maybe that. But God bless Steve and Dusty. They checked all my stuff when we were up there. And I came home yesterday, and I got home. I mean, there's no smell of anything. So God just protected me. And, you know, I was a woman up there driving through the mountains by myself. But God was with me. And so I just appreciate that. And thanks for your help.
Amen. God takes care of the little things, right? And I was fiddling on my phone because I wanted to bring this scripture to you this morning that God brought to me, because we're going to sing about our faith, how God gives us faith. I said, and remember when the little children wanted to come up to Jesus, and all the disciples were like, no, 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 this is serious stuff, you know. And Jesus said, you know, and he rebuked him. He said, the Bible says he rebuked those disciples. I feel like the disciples were getting rebuked a lot. Well, you know, I can attest, I can kind of relate to that. I feel like if I was a disciple, I'd also be getting rebuked. But it says, truly, truly, I say to you, unless you turn and become like children, that childlike faith, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven. Whoever humbles himself like this child is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. Whoever receives one such child in my name receives me. And then it gets serious. He says, but whoever causes one of these little children to believe in me, who believe in me, to sin, it would be better for him to have a great millstone fastened around his neck and be drowned into the depths of the sea. And that's serious. And so in this next song, we're going to be talking about faith. And how when we say something to our kids at a certain age, they take it as like gospel, right? They have faith in us. They have faith that we're going to provide for their needs. They have faith. They just know that they're not going to be hungry, that they're going to be well taken care of. They have that faith in us. And that's the example that Jesus gives. I want you to have that childlike faith in me. And so we're going to sing about that this morning. And it goes like this.
Give me faith to trust what you say, that you're good and your love is great. I'm broken inside, I give you my life.
Can we sing that again? Sing, give me faith, that childlike faith.
Give me faith to trust what you say, that you're good and your love is great. I'm broken inside, I give you my life.
Oh, I need you.
I need you. There's something in my heart, and break me apart. I need you to open my eyes, to see that you're shaping my life.
All I am.
All I am. I surrender. Give me faith to trust what you say, that you're good, your love is great. I'm broken. my heart and break me apart. I need you to pierce through the dark and cleanse every part of what you say.
many of you know that there's power when you call on the name of Jesus? Come on, give him praise this morning. There's power in the name of Jesus. So we call upon that name this morning. You lay down all of your burdens this morning at the feet of Jesus. I just want to speak the name of Jesus over every heart and every mind. 'Cause I know there is peace within your presence. I speak Jesus. Sing that verse again. I just want to speak the name of Jesus. Come on. Over every heart and every mind. I know there is peace within your presence. I speak Jesus.
Jesus.
break every stronghold, shine through the shadows, burn like a fire. I just want to speak the name of Jesus over every heart and every mind. Peace within your presence, I speak Jesus.
Sing it again.
I just want to speak the name of Jesus over every heart and every mind,
in every situation.
Cause I know there is peace within your presence. Speak
Jesus.
Shout Jesus from the mountains, Jesus in the streets, Jesus in the darkness over every enemy. Jesus for my family, I speak the holy shout Jesus from the mountains, Jesus in the streets, Jesus in the darkness over every enemy. Jesus for my family, I speak the holy name, Jesus. Shout Jesus from the mountains, Jesus in the darkness over every enemy. Jesus for my family, I speak the holy name, Jesus. Yeah. Shout Jesus from the mountain, Jesus in the streets, Jesus in the darkness over every enemy. Jesus for my family, I speak the holy name, Jesus. Your name is power, your name is healing, your name.
Father, we surrender to you. Increase our faith, Father God, for when we go through those valleys of the shadow of death. Increase our faith, Father God. Father, I just speak the name of Jesus over every heart and every mind in here. Take anxiety. Take depression. Fill it. Fill that hole with your presence, Jesus. Give them the peace that surpasses all understanding. Heavenly Father, I pray over this, the rest of this service today, that you would have your way. Father, anoint Jason this morning. Anoint Jason this morning. Give him your Holy Spirit fire. Holy Spirit, fall in this place. In Jesus' name we pray. You may be seated.